Well, thank you for joining us. I'm here at Authentic Taekwondo in Markham. I'm here with Master Farah. He's one of the owners. And so what does Authentic Taekwondo have to offer?
We have many different programs. Obviously, we have Taekwondo and kickboxing right now. But in about a week, we're also going to be implementing MMA, mixed martial arts, as well as ladies self-defense. But at the same time, we're going to be doing some boot camp and stuff like that, just because we have the space. So different programs for different people and different needs.
Excellent, excellent. Now, you've been in the game for a really long time. What are some of your accomplishments and something that you'll truly remember for the rest of your life?
You know, it's funny you mentioned that. I was, you know, as I was going through my training and stuff like that, sports psychology was one of the main aspects that really I try to focus on. And I remember I was reading this one particular book, and it said that anytime you're depressed and you're feeling down, you just try to think of a moment that you really felt you accomplished a lot, and that automatically boosts you. And you know, going back to your question, you know, what is that one moment? What is probably my greatest accomplishment is winning nationals after being, you know, involved in Taekwondo for about three and a half years, and going into the nationals thinking and hoping to just win one match, because the night before I was just praying, I hope I win just my first match, because the year previous I lost my first match. And then to come out at the end of the day and wear a gold medal around your neck, yeah, you know, it was just a permanent smile on my face for a very long time.
Absolutely, for sure.
And then to continue on from there, you know, going to world championships and then, you know, ranking top 8, making it to quarterfinals was an amazing accomplishment. And to be carded by the government and for them to pay for my school and to pay for my expenses, you know, that really was truly an amazing year. And you know, one of the accomplishments that I'll cherish for the rest of my life. Mm-hmm. And also, you know, also winning bronze at the Pan Am Championships and being part of the national team, you know, over and over again, it just really boosts my confidence and makes me feel good to be involved in the sport and to be able to give back to the community the experiences of game.
Yeah, sure. Now, coaching. Let's look at that. Who was your coach for the Pan Ams?
You know, I've been very fortunate to have my mentor, my big brother, you know, Tino Dos Santos, always by my side. Amazing guy, amazing guy. You know, for him to be by my side, even during color belt years, it's like, you know, unbelievable, because people generally, they don't really waste their time on you unless you show them something. And one way that you can show somebody is to show your dedication by getting your black belt. You know, I was just a color belt, maybe a yellow belt, orange belt, green belt, and you know, he kind of like said, okay, you know what, you have potential. And for him to recognize at such an early age, and to be my mentor, and to be like, you know, this is the path you need to go, was amazing. So he's really set the standard very high for me, and I'm trying my best to kind of, you know, follow in his footsteps as far as coaching and mentoring and being a great leader.
Yeah, as being now you're a club owner, you're going to have to pass on that knowledge to your students.
Absolutely.
Which is great, because you've learned from such a well-respected person in the Taekwondo industry, so that's great.
Absolutely, absolutely, sure. And he's definitely set the standards very high, and you know, I hope to be, you know, half as good as him. Absolutely. I think it would be a great accomplishment if I could be really just as half as good, because he's my idol. He's given me so much. He's always been there, you know, during my wins, you know, obviously he was on my coach, and even during my losses, you know, for him to call me, you know, 2 days later or 3 or a week later, you know, I know you're heartbroken, but you know, life goes on.
Looking up. You gotta do that with kids these days, for sure, to keep them on track. You know, I mean, when life ain't that bad, and there's always positive things to look at.
Absolutely. How many people drop out just because they lost? You know what? I suck. I'm no good. I gotta go. You know, this is not for me. But him to be like, listen, you're still a warrior. You know, you're still a, you know, you're still my boy. I still love you the same, despite winning or losing. You know, it boosts me, because when you lose, people think less of you. And when you win, you think you own the world.
Mm-hmm.
But in reality, the only person that really cares is you. You know, the world still goes, revolves, you know, it still turns, you know, and everything, the sun still shines and it still rains the next day. Life goes on, basically. But the only person that really adjusts to winning and losing is you.
Yeah.
So.
Now, talking about guiding kids, in Korea, Taekwondo is part of the school curriculum there. Do you think our school curriculum can benefit from Taekwondo being in the school?
Absolutely, and I think one person is actually trying to implement that. I think one person that's trying to do that is Grandmaster Yang Su Chang, who is also my master instructor. You know, he's always has great ideas for the future of the sport and for the future of the art and martial arts in general. And I think he's trying very hard to implement that. You know, obviously he's trying to do the NCCP and the, getting people to have their coaching certificate so that they have an avenue to follow. So not just anybody can say, well, you know, I am a grandmaster and learn from me. But no, you have the credentials to prove it. And once you have the credentials to prove it, then, you know, we can also implement that to say, well, you have the credentials, you have the ability to teach other people. Why don't we implement it systematically so that it's within the education system? And I think he's trying to do that, and I think that's an amazing idea, simply because Taekwondo has definitely changed my life, and I think it has changed a lot of other people's lives and people around me, and we see the benefits of it. And I think that by focusing on the tenets of Taekwondo and what it brings to kids and people in general, I think by implementing that in our system, the future generations, the education system, the people...
Confidence for the kids and stuff like that too. And I think bullying would actually kind of cool down too, because everyone's kind of like on the same level.
Absolutely.
Right? So there's no more picking on Joey or whatever, you know what I mean? There's none of that anymore, which is great.
Absolutely. And I think that's the greatest part, is that we deal with bullying in Taekwondo. You know, we deal with the social aspects of it. You know, you're an individual, but it requires a team to train with. I mean, it doesn't matter how good you are. To be there by yourself, day in and day out, you know, we've all been there. Mm-hmm. We know it's tough. But to get us to that next level, we need people to help us. Yeah. And we realize that as much as it's an individual sport, we need other people. And this is kind of like the same thing in bullying. It's like, you know, if I choose to exclude you from my group, maybe one day I'll need you. So, you know, it's important to play fair and be kind and be generous to everybody, because you never know how you might end up meeting that person. Absolutely. And at the same time, you know, in martial arts, you need to deal with bullying by having that confidence to say, you know what,
I don't want to talk to you.
Patience, yeah.
Yeah, you're just kind of like, I know what I can do. Just, you know, relax. And half the time, the Taekwondo kids are the ones that actually walk away from fights and whatnot, because they know where they stand.
Absolutely.
And I think that's good. Now, another thing, like, talk about your school. How many square feet you got here?
I think there's about 4,000 square feet, and then I have the upstairs as well. So I'm planning on doing, you know, obviously I have the space for it, which makes me feel comfortable to run different programs.
Absolutely.
And I feel very, like I said, you know, in my speech earlier, when you missed it, I feel very fortunate to have the space. Yeah. If I had guessed 10 years, you know, when I was planning on having a school eventually, to have a place like this, I would never think possible. But you know, the space allows me to play around with different activities and different martial arts, and just focusing on the health and the physical, the mental, the spiritual. Well, this is the place to do it.
Your school instructors, how many school instructors do you have in the system?
Right now, it's myself, Dr. Gibbs, Master Randy Joseph, Master Tom Ottlinger, Mr. Ali Kapoor, and Master Dominique Boshart will also be a guest instructor once in a while. So, you know what, we have a great pool of instructors, you know, so much to offer. And also Mr. Salim Syed, who's the MMA instructor, he'll be here as well. So all these very well-rounded instructors. Again, I feel so fortunate.
That's great. Well, to have that kind of background is absolutely great. What are your school hours? Do you operate mostly in the evening?
Mostly in the evening as of right now, but obviously as the program grows, then the schedule will grow with it. Right now we have children's class from 6 to 7, and we have kickboxing from 7 to 8, and our classes from 8 to 9. And that kind of generally follows throughout the week.
Yeah, that's great. Well, thanks for joining.
Thank you for having me.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And we'll check you guys later. Take care.